Good morning.
Good morning.
My grounding cord is this deep, darkish red color.
Mine is
what gold. Color is your grounding cord? Yeah.
Mine is really golden, this melted gold.
Thank you for arranging this possibility coaching session. What can I do for you? What's going on?
I feel angry mostly. That no, just that in my teams, I have to keep policing people to hold the space in integrity.
Could you close your eyes, please? Mm-hmm. And this phrase, policing people, you just sink down. It has an experience with it. There's an experience, a whole five-body experience that goes along with this thing about policing people. You have to police people. It's somehow you're forced. You're the one who has to police people. Yeah, just let that get bigger, please. You're doing super. Just keep letting it get bigger. And let the sounds out. You're going to use a towel to keep the sound not so loud. Go ahead. Yeah. Great. Great. Keep going. Yes. What's that other feeling? What is that second feeling? That one. What is that one? Go, go, fear. Go. Okay, go, go. Yes. Yes.
I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it.
This is the sense of that is really deep in your cells. Can you feel that? It's in your whole nervous system.
I'm so tired of doing it.
Can you sink down into the feeling and let me know? Please tell me a time when you had this same feeling before. The same, I don't want to do this policing stuff.
I think it was when I was younger.
How old? How old are you?
Six, seven.
Okay.
That's the picture I get.
What was happening? You had something about your sister. You said something about your sister. But this sounds pure. Let that come out big. If it's fear, let it be fear. If it's anger, let it be anger. Try to not mix the two. Keep. Fear about what is it? Say it.
I'm 8 years old and I'm in New Caledonia. We just moved.
Yes. Keep going.
To this new country and oh, and my parents, they hate each other. They just, okay. And so my mom decides to move in another apartment. She went to live somewhere else, just
just what?
Like for the night. Like she would still be there during the day, but
keep going. What's this fear about? This huge fear. What's happening?
Okay, I need to protect my sister. I need to protect my sisters.
From what?
I think it's if they like don't, like if they misbehave,
then what would happen if they
then
misbehave?
Also they will have to leave. They will have to leave the
house. If they misbehave, they will have to leave.
Yes.
So they will be sent away by your father or what? Why would they have to leave?
Yeah, because my father didn't want to have unruly, like misbehaving women around.
Stay with the feelings. You're doing great. Your father did not want to have misbehaving, unruly women around.
It's
and
hard.
Your sisters. If your sisters are unruly or misbehaving, they'll be sent away, like your mother.
Yes. And so I have to police them.
Okay.
To make sure that they don't misbehave.
There's some, I think there's some bigger fear. There's some central fear. In, you're mixing two feelings together right now. Can you tell me what the two feelings are?
Yeah, fear and sadness.
What's the sadness about?
Then I will lose them. Yeah.
Why does that make you sad?
I'm sad that they can't, like, oh, we can't be just the way we want to be. That there's all these rules.
I want to ask a slightly different question.
Yeah.
What's your sadness about losing sisters? What's your sadness about missing sisterhood? Let it get bigger. Will you put your hand over your heart? Put your hand up by your heart. Hold your heart so it's protected, but let it get bigger. What is your sadness about missing sisterhood? All the way big.
I'm missing sisters to play with.
I want to take this one step further. You're a very powerful creator person. You're a game world builder. You're... Why do you resist? What's the resistance in you of creating sisters to play with?
I mean,
what's the problem with that?
The first answer I get is they can't.
Let it get bigger, okay? Let the sensation get bigger. I'm not so interested in answers. We're on a journey here.
Yeah.
Follow the journey. What's the block? What's the resistance to creating sisters to play with? You're very sad about not having sisters to play with. You could create sisters to play with, but there's something blocking you. There's another big feeling in there. Just let the next layer come. The next layer come up. Just drop into it. Yeah. That one. Let that get bigger. Let it get bigger. Let the sensation come. There's something about not okay. It's not going to work. Something not okay, but to create sisters to play with. Something about that. Or you would be doing it. Go, go, go.
I don't want to be the one to do it.
Because?
Because I don't want to be responsible for it.
Yes, because?
I think it's better if I train them and then they go...
Look at this. These are two big words. These words are too big. Okay? Drop out of your head. There's a huge sensation in your body about this. It's huge. Just go the next layer down. You're on it. It's this responsible thing. Let that get big. What's the thing? Yes. I hear three feelings in there. Tell me what they are. What's the fear about?
The fear about is that if they play with me, then it will be dangerous.
Okay. For who?
For them.
Because? I want you to follow this back. This is a big one. Follow this back. Something happened. Something happened. Just let it come back in your bodies, okay? I don't know if it's this lifetime, another lifetime, but something happened. Or it will be dangerous for them if they play with you. There's a little resistance in you.
Yeah.
It's like a little inner block. Receiving clarity about past life stuff. Okay, you have this little film. It's like some kind of a barrier to blocking the experience from past life stuff. And so I'm asking you to relax the barrier. For right now, just relax this barrier. Just drop that on the floor. I'm asking you to relax this barrier that you have against all your previous history. You have a lot of previous history. Some barrier up to block that from coming to you, and you need the information.
I don't want.
drop the film, drop the barrier.
I don't want to have lived so long, like so many times.
Okay, well, that's a different process. Drop the barrier so you can get this information for right now. You can put the barrier up later, but drop it for right now. Something happened. It will be dangerous for your sisters if they play with you. What happened?
We're running.
You're outside?
Yeah, outside.
Or it's inside?
Dark. No, outside it's dark.
Outside, dark, forest, running.
We're wearing this like really long dress, like ankle.
Yeah.
Ankle size dress. And
who's we? Who's we?
A woman, a number of them, not so many, maybe. Like four, five, six.
Five women.
I can't tell. It's like we're all.
How old? Running. How old are you?
20s. How old are you? In our 20s.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you're running towards something or running away from something?
Running away. We're running away. I can hear the dogs.
You're running away from dogs. And what would. I'm going to ask you to click your clicker and go back about 15 minutes or half hour. What were you doing before the dog started chasing you? Inside or outside? Inside or outside? 30 minutes earlier.
Inside.
Okay, you're inside with the same women or what?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, and what's happening?
We're sitting around a fire. Inside a house.
Okay. All right. Okay. And what's happening?
We're discussing.
Okay. What are you discussing?
About how the woman can take over the city, like lead the city. Like, well, what would mm-hmm. be the plan?
So high level fun.
Yeah, but it wasn't just fantasy.
Yeah, I know. I get it. It was real stuff. Okay, so you're figuring this out. You're sitting around inside the house with the women. What were you feeling at the time? What was your sense of the experiment right then? What was your sense?
Yeah, ecstasy. A lot of ecstasy. There was a lot like joy, but also like fear and some
and yeah. power.
Yeah. Yeah.
Remember this thing I had this conversation with you before about it's time for you to move into power. Remember you just told me that in this, the four enemies.
Yeah, yeah.
The person on the path and you're shifting from clarity to power. And there's some block about power. Stay in your body, stay with the feelings. You're in this circle or in this group of women inside the house, it's nighttime.
And I start feeling really scared. I'm like, something's not right.
Hold on a second. You're going just a little too fast. You're jumping over this thing. Here's a circle of women. Your circle of women organizing how to take over the city, the village. How to replace the cruelty or stupidity or belligerence or ignorance of whoever's probably the men running the city. Okay, this is powerful. And you were said you had an ecstasy and this joy and fear. And that you could sense the power of what you were doing. You were starting to take power. So So there's something happened in this whole thing that we're going to go through. Something happened with you and power. So I want you to tell me while we're going along, what happened with you and power? Okay.
Okay.
But do you get how the power was there? Do you get that?
Yeah.
You had a sense of power. Okay, you were moving into power from then. You had to have clarity already. And here you are moving into power with a group of women. And then you started sensing something was wrong. Your intuition, you heard something, something's wrong. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Go ahead, what happened? What's wrong? Yes. Yes. What's that?
I don't know.
Say the words. I don't know if it's true.
I don't know if it's true, but I
have a sense. Doesn't matter. It will feel like you're making it up.
I get something that the other women don't get, and I get scared about it.
What is it you get? What do you get?
Today I would say radical responsibility, or
okay.
The power.
Yes, keep going. The power of what?
The power of radical responsibility.
Yes.
My job.
Yes. And you get that, and they don't.
I sort of, we're in this circle, and it comes in, and I just get scared, and
Why are you afraid of it?
I don't get it. I don't know why the other women don't get it. I'm trying to explain something. Mm-hmm. And I feel this. The separation.
Uh-huh. Yes. So it's something like you have the matrix to get radical responsibility, and they don't have the matrix to hold it. They don't have the matrix to get it.
I don't understand.
Mm-hmm.
Because there was no hierarchy.
Yeah,
then all of a sudden it feels like there's a hierarchy, and then it's just like the men that we were trying to change, we were trying to take over. Yes. And it's like happening to me.
Yes.
Oh! I don't want it to happen to me.
Yeah.
I don't want it.
So what did you decide? In that moment, what did you decide?
I don't want it.
Say the whole sentence, okay? I don't want this
power coming into me.
Okay. The power from what? Power from what?
Oh, this like burning, like this, this like mission, this like thing coming in me saying I have to do it. I have to do this. I have to do it this way. I have to do it this way. And that was not the plan. That was not what we had. Like that was not where we were.
So you had to do it this way, meaning radical responsibility way.
Yeah.
And you had another plan.
Before, yeah.
Mm-hmm. What were you going to say?
And then I can feel this, like, this energy, and it's like, and then I started telling them what to do, but it wasn't like that before. It wasn't like that before.
Okay.
I can feel, and I'm like, no, I'm looking at myself doing it, and I'm saying, what are you doing? You're destroying everything. What are you doing? Are you creating this hierarchy?
Mm-hmm.
But in a way, it's like I can't stop it.
Mm-hmm. I want to tell you something now that you did not know then. just to help you organize this, all right?
Okay.
You did not know about the two kinds of hierarchy.
Wait a second.
There are two kinds of hierarchy.
Wait.
Don't open your eyes. I'm writing notes. You can read it later.
Okay.
There are these two kinds of hierarchy. One is a structural power hierarchy. It's a design. It's a forced, and it's permanent. It's supposed to be permanent hierarchy, so that those who are in that hierarchy are forced ongoingly to bow down before those higher up in the hierarchy. That is the hierarchy that was existing in the village where you were. There was this power struggles and people trying to hold power, get power in this structural power hierarchy. What was happening for you is a different kind of hierarchy. It's the hierarchy of whoever gets the good idea. I'm sure you've been in groups where somebody says, hey, I have an idea. Okay, this is it's temporary. This is the temporary teamwork hierarchy. It's just, you don't know who is going to be the antenna for the good idea. It just happens and then people use it or don't use it. But somebody has to stick their hand up, be the lightning rod where the good idea comes into your team, and then you're back, you know, once the team has the idea, that hierarchy is over. And so this was a very stressful time where you just happened to be the one getting the good idea for the team. So it's a totally different kind of hierarchy, but you were not aware of that before. So once the team gets the idea, the hierarchy is over. And then somebody else gets a new idea, or you get another new idea. But it has to do with, it's a temporary source of good ideas, and that's a different kind of hierarchy. Okay? But you couldn't figure that out. You didn't have time to figure that out because something else was happening. What else was happening? Something else is going wrong. In addition to all that, something else is happening.
Yeah.
You're doing super with this. You're doing great.
I just want to say that I feel like I'm floating out. You know, that we were in this circle and sort of we were bonded.
Okay.
In this circle, and then I feel like I'm floating out of that bond. I mean, maybe that's one of the decisions I made about.
Say the decision.
Yeah, like, if I don't agree, like, I don't know if I change my mind, if something happens, like, that I change my mind, then I can't be in the circle anymore. I have to leave.
And so you want to block new, you want to block the change.
It's not like that. It's it's more, I can never be in a circle again.
Okay. Because
because I don't want to block the next idea.
Say that last again, because I want to what the next because idea?
I don't want to block the next idea. Like, I don't want to block the next process.
Got it.
I don't know. And this is like, I don't know. This is part of like being in a team is so slow. Being in a circle is so slow.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's like either I can be myself or I can be in a circle.
Okay. Yep.
And I somehow I chose to be myself. More. Like, I choose to be myself more than being in a circle.
Yes. Okay. The other new thing that you didn't know about is there are different kinds of circles. And so there's sort of being with circles, about being with, and there's a collaborative circle, co-creative circle. And it seems like you were identified with or wanting to be in a being with circle. And you didn't have the idea of a collaborative circle. And so you were trying to hold on to the being with circle of sisters. And all of a sudden, if you get a new idea, you're jumping into a collaborative circle and they weren't with you yet. There wasn't time to discuss this or figure that out. And so suddenly you were getting new ideas and could not shift into a collaborative circle. And so you made these decisions then, either being in a circle is too slow, or I can either be yourself or be in a circle, or so I chose to be with myself more. You made this whole decision about that.
Yeah, I mean, there's something about like this fear of imposing what I want, like what I like, I mean, it relates to what's happening like right now in this life about how can I be sure that like what I want is what the circle wants? And so, and I don't even want to figure this out. I'm like, people do what they want, and who am I to tell them this is the circle to be, you know, this is the kind of circle I want to be in. And so I'm like, I'm floating, and I see them like so like together, like so like being with together and happy together. And it's like, if I come in with that thing, I'm gonna destroy that. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna destroy that level of ecstasy. Or
I want to ask you a question.
Yeah.
Who's the space holder of that group, of that circle? Right. Who's the space holder of that circle?
There were none. It was like that. There were none. It was like we were.
Slow down. Who's the space holder of the circle? If you were not there, would the circle still have existed? Would it have come together if you were not there?
I don't have a sense that they would not have. Like, it was really, I think if either one were missing, we would not meet.
Please say that again.
Is that if any one of us were missing,
mm-hmm.
it wouldn't have worked. I don't know, right? I don't have a sense that I was the space holder, and maybe I'm fooling myself.
I want to ask you a question. This group of women, was it an angel? Had you built an angel?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. It's a rare thing. It's a rare and precious thing.
And I destroyed it.
You destroyed it by
having this like flow of energy come in, like this clarity or this like assuredness that we had to do things differently.
What? Can you give one example of what you would have to do differently?
We were trying to, I don't, somehow we would try to be nice, I think, in a sense. Like, we were trying to, convince people, or talk to people, or like, instead of like standing in the thing and inviting people and we would try to merge with them. And I was like,
mm-hmm.
No, we have something amazing and we want people to like, this is it, something like that. And we don't have to dilute.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, and I feel angry and sad.
Because? Angry about?
Because I think I can feel how I'm like still attached to this like diluting and like not really standing in
and you're still attached to it because
like I feel stuck in between. I'm stuck in between. I'm okay. Stuck between like wanting to join the circle again and wanting to be myself, and it's like, and I keep flipping.
Okay. So what I hear you saying is, can you still hear me? What I hear you saying, can you hear me?
Yeah.
What I hear you saying is that you are flipping between having this or that.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a certain kind of universe. There's a certain kind of universe where you can either have this or that.
Yeah.
I want to ask you a question. Tell me when you're ready.
I'm ready.
Who would you have to be? Who would you have to become? Who would you have to be to have this and that?
They feel so contradictory.
They are. It doesn't have to happen at the same moment in the same space with the same people. Who would you have to become to be able to have this and that?
I mean, I guess, like, sort of, I don't know, like, the person I am right now, there's, I have some circles of being with, and then I have, I do my thing.
What would you call that sort of person?
I'm schizophrenic.
Could you find another word?
I don't know, I have parts. I don't know, sometimes I just feel like I'm pretending, like I just like shift from one identity to the next. I'm just like pretending or something.
Have you anchored yourself into a fantasy world that it can always be the same? Or it should always be the same.
I don't know if it's like the whole, it should always be the same, but it's sort of like when, if I've reached a moment of being with a collaboration, then I think it's gonna keep going like that, and I don't need to have whatever I would call it, my sword out. Like, I don't need to renegotiate that. I think it's going to just go forever and we would grow together. And mm-hmm. Because I miss it. And I love it so much when it's like that, that I then want to hold on to it and like not pretend that it's not going to change.
Have you ever heard this story of the princess? And then she's waiting until the prince rides up on the white horse and grabs her and throws her on the back of the horse, and they ride off and create their own kingdom and they live happily ever after.
Yeah.
Have you been holding on to that?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah. It's a good fantasy. It's a great fantasy. It's a popular fantasy. there's not much connection between that fantasy and the world. I think that what you're experiencing is this conflict of entering reality.
Can you say it again?
When you enter reality, it conflicts with the fantasy.
Yep.
And it's a horrible conflict. It's very painful.
I think it's like I made a decision. I mean, I can feel the conflict and I'm like, okay, why did I make this fantasy world? And it's because I was like, I think when I was in that moment, I made this wish. I wish that in a way that this will never happen again. I wish that we would grow, that I wish that I would find a circle or be in a circle where we all like grow together. With each other, right? It's this like, I'm like, I can feel this wish. It's like,
You had this experience that it was possible. You had the vision that it was possible, but it wasn't just the vision. We had that experience with these women.
I had the experience before. And it was so great. Mm-hmm. And when that thing happened, it was not great at all.
Yeah.
So I sort of put this like thing in me. We had a wish to find this circle. That, like, to find the circle I had again, like, find the sensation I had before in that circle.
Yeah. Yeah. The memory of the experience of the growing together and oneness in the circle is a map, and the map is in your body. I don't know, there's this thing about chocolate cake or chocolate mousse au chocolat. It's like, every now and then, I sit before a bowl of perfect mousse au chocolat.
Yeah.
What is that like for you?
I just eat it.
And then
the next one is not so perfect.
Yeah. But don't you want the mousse au chocolat that's perfect to never end?
Yeah, and for me to never get full and like all those other things.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, you had a short moment in this house with these women, possibly a couple of times, meeting like this before the dogs came. You weren't together long enough to get tired of eating the mousse au chocolat. So you thought that you could find it again. It could go on, and that's what the map was. You put the map in your body and you've been looking for that. And it has a lot of fear and anger and sadness and the old decisions about this that are still operating. for you. So this thing, my question was, who would you have to become to create for yourself this and that? Your answer was schizophrenic. And it implied that, well, it can be whole, it can be the same, it can stay one, it should all hang together, and it should be the one thing, except there's a part of you that wants also the creation thing, the invention thing. Okay. Excuse me. And so what you're saying is there's this conflict in you between wanting to be the one thing and wanting to be the invention circle. Those are two different kinds of spaces. So who would you have to become to have both? Because previous to now, it's only been this or that, and that has created a devastating struggle in you.
I don't know, I have a sense of like some kind of wave, like the wave has a moment where it goes up and a moment where it goes down, and it's both.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's kind of... like... I don't know how I can feel this like compart things. And so I'm noticing mm-hmm. my relationship with like women I can really create this being with and this like sharing space and then this other moment where it's like, well, I'm like having ideas or having the sword out or making proposals or moving things forward and maybe like I try to fit when I needed to use the sword, I'm trying to keep it into the oneness. Like that I've mixed up which space is which or something.
Mm-hmm. What kind of a profession, what kind of person would you need to be to own both possibilities?
A sworded angel.
Okay.
I don't know. I mean, it's like, I don't get it about like being a sorceress or a wizard or like... a space holder. I don't get it.
Well, the thing is, they all apply. If you're going to be an archetypal force of nature, if you're going to serve your archetypal lineage, you will need the sworded angel. Then you will be the wizard or the sorceress or the space holder. Those function, they all function in this multiple universe. They work in multiple universes. You know, if there was only one space, you would not need a space holder, like you said. You need a space holder because there are multiple spaces. You get that? So if there's, you know, if there's only one space, you don't need a space holder. Like you had that experience in the circle with no space holder here, but we're talking about because there are multiple spaces, you need a space holder. So it can get there, and so it can, you can go where it wants to navigate space. So
a multi-dimensional space navigator.
Yeah, that's who you would need to be. Are you that?
Yeah, I mean, yes. I notice how I like froze. This one person, I like froze her into this one, this like circle of one. Yeah. I wanted her to be there like the whole time.
Yeah.
Exactly. And then when she wasn't, I was so angry. I fought a guy. I didn't want to shift. Because then I was going to lose her as also being part of the one circle.
Apologizing to who?
To her.
Your team? To what?
Yeah.
What would your apology be? What do you need to say?
That I froze you in one team. I only froze you in the one team, like in the angel team. And I didn't want you to be in the collaboration team. Like I banished you from the collaboration team. I'm sorry.
When I was asking you what you would need to be, you would say things like wizard, sorceress, space navigator, multidimensional, sworded angel. You did not say alchemist. And the essential element or core element of alchemy is a simple phrase. It goes like this. This too shall pass. Have you heard this before?
Yeah, I don't think I understand it in a way that I felt like it was saying all the emotion will pass. The conflict will pass, but it's like also the ecstasy over one thing, like it cannot last forever.
Yeah. So when things are really bad, this too shall pass is one of the most powerful, wonderful things you can experience. But when things are really good, it's one of the most horrible things you can experience. But it doesn't go away. The truth of it does not go away. So will you do that apology or those apologies when you in your next couple of weeks?
Yes.
So I know we've been going on for a while, but I think it would be important to complete the dog thing. So you keep your eyes closed, please.
Yeah.
Do you have some water there? Could you drink a little water, please? So that this too shall pass, you get to have this one circle destroyed, which is a really wonderful thing, you know, ending. And then there's this time of running through the forest with the dogs chasing you. And we probably can foresee the outcome of what that is, which is a horrible thing. And just that too shall pass. All right. So that's why we're going into it. There's something in there of value, because that's where we were first when we came back in here. That's where we landed first. So there's value there. So you just, as horrible, as excruciating as it will be, it too shall pass. So are you ready for this?
Yeah.
So you're meeting in the circle. You have five or six other women.
I'm having this experience.
Say it again.
It is the moment where I'm having this experience of this thing coming into me, and I'm about to say something, and the words never come out because there's somebody knocks at the door. And
okay, wait. Okay, what were the words that never came out? What were the words?
This is not the way, there's another way.
This is not the way. There is another way. What is the other way?
Stand in our power, like stand in our clarity and welcome people into this. And stand in there, yes. Instead of sneaking. I felt like I had this sense that like the plan before was about kind of sneaking and whispering in one person's ear. And it was like not owning. What we were, everybody, like every human being that is like whispering is like so degrading.
It's so what did you say? Irritating?
Degrading, like
degrading.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was an honoring. Like what is possible?
Yeah. So I ask you a request. Will you keep saying this? Will you say it now, these days? Will you say it over and over in different ways?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. So the door, somebody knocked on the door in exactly the moment before you were able to say all this.
Yeah, and it's a woman. She's younger than us, but she was ready to come into our circle. She's getting ready.
Oh, okay.
And she says, "They're coming. You have to leave. You have to leave. They're coming."
So she warned you.
Yes.
She had to warn you.
Yeah. And there was another, okay. We had another door. We had another door on the other side of the house.
And okay.
We just started running. We left everything. Mm-hmm. I just remember being just running, being out of breath, and looking at the other woman running, and we were in the woods and it was dark and some of us kept falling and we had to stand up and keep running.
Keep going.
And I heard the dogs and the people were on horses, but the dogs were faster. They were barking.
Yep.
I just remember I tripped and I fell.
Yes.
And I hit my head on the side,
okay,
like this. And I,
yeah.
I just said, so all my sisters, they kept running and then,
keep going. Let the sounds out all the way big. Sounds out all the way big.
I decided to die really quickly. I just didn't want. I didn't. I just left. While the dog were fighting me.
That's where this dog thing comes from. What did you decide about dogs?
They're going to bite me. They're going to kill me.
What else did you decide on your way out when you left quickly like that? And you saw the other women running and being attacked by the dogs going down. What did you decide?
We'll never make it. From this despair, oh God, it's sort of like, oh, one more time. One more time. We won't make it. And I can feel it like in my system that I do have that. I'm like, we won't make it. Doesn't stop me from trying again, but it's pretty desperate.
How does it not stop you from trying again?
I think about from the other map, like the ecstasy of just being in that space is worth it. Be worth it.
Yeah.
But it's kind of like I can feel this like sigh, being like, what did I do wrong? Sort of this like, okay, game over. What did I do wrong?
And what did you do wrong? What would you say?
I think, maybe this thing that I got at the end, that the whispering thing is not the way.
So you were whispering, that's what you did wrong? I have a proposal. The proposal is you did nothing wrong. That you're on this learning journey and you learned things, but you did nothing wrong. Can you say that?
Yeah. I did nothing wrong. I'm on this learning journey. I was one step in learning. I'm amazed about this certainty of, you know, I'm about to die and I'm just, it's one game over. But now, you know, it's like, I'll come back. I'll be back. I'm surprised about that certainty.
Yeah. But then what you're saying is it's not so bad to know that you've been around before. You were saying before that you didn't want to know how many lives you've lived.
Yeah.
Remember that? And so now we're discovering that, well, sometimes it's not so bad if you know you've lived lives before. It's, I'll be back.
Yeah.
You want to say that in your own words?
It's not so bad to have an experience of having lived all those lives. It's like, each one is a learning step. Like each one has its own ecstasy, but also a lot of its own pain. And I think I'm like trying to not experience both, like the pain of these lives, but also the ecstasy of them. I miss them, I think. Like, I didn't get this thing of this too shall pass. I mean, I had such great times.
Mm-hmm.
And it had to come to an end, and it's like, yeah, the pain that it has to come to an end.
Mm-hmm. It's not like that you did something wrong. It has to come to an end.
Yeah. I can feel it, this like wish that it would like just go on forever.
That's the fantasy world. It's only a fantasy world, it's all. It's not good or bad, it's just a technology called fantasy world. You know, and it takes you away from reality. That's what it does. I mean, for me, and I think I got it from Lee Lozowick actually, but it was this thing about, you know, I'd be sitting with him at lunch and he'd be totally enjoying this salad and the salad dressing and the leaves and the vegetables and just totally enjoying it. And then he'd look at me, when he was finished, he'd basically almost lick his plate. And then he'd look at me and go, now I have to wait. You know, because he's full. The salad's gone and he's full and it's over. And, you know, a lot of these things, we don't get to control when it comes back. We don't get to control when the ecstasy and miraculous spaces, the oneness and the harmony, you know, when that resonates all perfectly again, we don't get to control that. So a lot of it is waiting. A lot of it is practicing. A lot of it is building matrix, you know, learning new stuff, trying experiments, and waiting. What I want to ask is, do you need to complete anything with the women who are being killed by the dogs like you and who were in the circle with you just before then? Let's try this. Will you click your clicker and be back in the circle with the women in the house? And it's a new meeting. It's not the same meeting, it's a new meeting. And just say whatever you need to say. Start with hello.
Hello. And they will greet me.
Yes.
I'm so sad that our last meeting was cut short. I had this amazing information, like energy coming through me just before. The warning. And I got scared. I get really scared about it. Because I thought that I would lose you. That I would be creating a hierarchy, the exact thing that we were trying to take down somehow. And I've been carrying.
What did they say?
They kind of nod. It was so fast that it doesn't seem like they remember what was happening.
They don't remember this thing happening for you.
They don't remember that. Yeah.
Yeah. You were going to say something else then.
Yeah. I got so scared that if I used that in our circle, that it would destroy a circle. If I used that energy of this information in our circle, then it would be over. And the truth is, it would have been that particular circle, the way it was, it would have been over and something, and we would have created something else. But I didn't know how to be okay with that circle, like that space to be over.
And Chloe, will you check in yourself? Because it is not over. That circle never ended. A circle has no end.
Yeah, the space then.
Yeah, but you're denying what I just said.
Okay.
Find in yourself, it's obvious. It is so obvious that circle has never ended. Why is it obvious?
Because I can go back there whenever.
You still experience it. You still have the experience that cannot be taken away from you ever. Circle has no end.
How does that fit with this too shall pass?
Yeah, it did. Like this, in reality, it's gone, but it cannot be taken away from you. It can't be taken away from you. It has become part of you. So you don't have to defend it. You don't have to hide it. It's become part of who you are. Just like you said, the learnings from each lifetime learnings, they become part of who you are. So you were talking to the ladies and you were just explaining what happened.
Yeah, and actually there's one woman who says that she was having the same experience the same time as me.
Can you look in her eyes? Just look in her eyes and let the knowing go back and forth between them. And you aren't alone. You are not alone. It did not make you alone.
She was scared too. Somehow the other women, they're just there and smiling, and they're there in this circle, and they're feeling ecstatic about being there in that circle. There's no resentment, blaming or whatever about what happened.
No conflict about that.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for trying this with me and creating this circle and having so much fun. Being okay with having so much fun. They're just not.
Can you take a deep breath, please? What would be your parting message for them?
I think I can see you around. Yeah, see you in the next body. If it happens.
Yeah, you could just say, I'm going to go on about my circle making. I'm going to get back to work circle making.
Yeah, I'm going to go back to circle making. Different kind of circles. Different spaces. They say good luck.
OK. Okay, then you click your clicker and come back into this room where you are. Take another deep breath. Slowly open your eyes. There's so much in this that it's not time to make new decisions or anything. So I have good notes, I'll get them to you. And you can review the notes, I would say a couple times for the next 3 weeks, each like two or three times a week, just go through the notes. There's 5 pages of notes. And just notice what it does to your awareness and what's possible. And some don't worry about trying to make new decisions, but you already have the matrix for new formulations to come, new decisions to come. And then that could lead into some more experiments for you to try as you become this and that. Who are you that can create this and that? And getting okay with being that kind of a person rather than being in despair of being a person who wanted this, only this, and trying to fight for it and defend it and have it not be there and having lost it and having like all that, missing it, being that kind of a person. So take your time in the next weeks, do experiments, find out who it is to be a person who can create this and that, what that does for your world. And thank you for your trust during this process. You did fantastic. I would encourage you to take a little nap or take a little walk out in the sun if you can, just to integrate. Don't try to do any big things today if you can help it. Don't just kind of let your system integrate all that, because there's a huge multi-dimensions that were awakened and reconnected, and let them come back together, let them reorder themselves. Okay. Do you have any questions right now or anything else?
No, sharing about like, I really, now I can see how in a lot of the circles that I hold, I have this, I'm trying to get back to the circle. And every time somebody's trying to like, quote unquote, break the circle or question it or resist it. And I'm like, oh, like, why would somebody do that? And so I have this like movement towards just one instead of like dancing between the two. So yeah, always had this anger or this being offended, and I think it was fear behind it that somebody would question it or yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, so you have my number. Let me know if you need anything. And thanks again for your trust and for the work.
Thank you.